Hey guys, so I'm standing in the middle of the Musee d'Orsay in the middle of Paris, and this building has an interesting history. If you look up here, there's a big old clock up there, and then the ceiling, if you look, it's a very large arch barrel vault that goes all the way to the back there. And you might be thinking this architecture is a bit unique for a museum, and you're right, and it didn't start out as a museum, actually. It was started construction in 1898, I believe. It was opened by 1900, and it was used as a train station for Universal Exposition in the year 1900. And it functioned as a train station until 1939, and by then, the trains that were being used, that were in service, were much longer than the platforms in this train station could support. And so it was used for some regional transportation, and then it got shut down. It was used for a bunch of other miscellaneous things. And in the 1970s, it was actually slated for demolition. And I'll just pan around here so you can see some of this architecture here. So it was slated for demolition, and the Minister of, can't remember who it was. I think it was the museums. Someone had the idea, hey, let's not demolish it. Let's go ahead and turn it into a museum. And so they had a competition, and three young architects actually won that competition, and they renovated the place. Another architect did all these interiors, which are very modern. It's actually all these like panelized stone cladding systems mixed with some metal, and very modern. But so those four architects, they renovated this and converted it into a five-floor museum, and now it houses some of the greatest works in Paris and in the world. I think it's ranked number 2 in Paris, second to the Louvre, and number 10 in the world as far as number of visitors and the value of the collection. So just real interesting story of adaptive reuse, and the building is now historic. It was put on the historic register back in 1978. And it finally opened. The renovation ended in 1986, so it took about 8 years for the whole renovation process to transform this from an unused railway station that was going to be demolished into the historic museum that it is today. So, you know, when you're looking at your property, sometimes tearing it down is the right answer if you're looking at renovation. But in this case, you know, this museum had a lot of history, and now 119 years after its initial use as a railway station, we get to enjoy it as a museum. So, something to keep in mind. If you like this video, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time, I'm Tim Alatorre with Domum. Bye.